Pacquiao would want a possible fifth fight with Juan Manuel Marquez to be held outside of the U.S. because of taxes. Promoter Bob Arum's preference is for the fight to be held in Vegas, but Arum says Pacquiao's concerned about the additional money he'd lose to the government if the fight were held in Vegas. So here's the question. What does this say about Manny Pacquiao? And I'll start with you first, Stephen.
Well, what it says is that Floyd Mayweather Jr., Money Mayweather, Pretty Boy Floyd, was absolutely right when he brought up the fact that there were other mitigating circumstances that contributed to him and Manny Pacquiao never fighting in the first place. My only regret, and don't get me wrong, let me pause for a second, step back. I did not like seeing Manny Pacquiao, no matter how much I joke about it, because I love the sport of boxing. Manny Pacquiao was right here, incredibly nice guy. I really didn't like seeing him go down like that.
Oh, please.
I really didn't. I would not have minded him getting staggered, skipped, and getting dropped in 10 seconds or whatever the case. You know, technical knockout kind of thing, you get stunned. I didn't like seeing the boy put to sleep.
He was up in 10 seconds. He was fine.
What smelling salts did they give to wake him up after a minute?
That's fine.
Okay, I didn't like seeing his wife screaming crying at ringside. Really broke my heart.
Yeah, it really did.
Yeah, I'm serious. I mean, I know I'm smiling, but it really did. I didn't like seeing that. I really didn't, okay? But I did. I didn't mind seeing him lose. I wanted to see him lose, because remember, I picked Marquez to win that fight by decision. I wanted to see him lose to Floyd Mayweather Jr. Floyd Mayweather would have put him to sleep like that, too. All I'm saying is, in the end, this just highlights for me that Floyd is absolutely right when he talked about the issues. Manny Pacquiao has got some financial issues. Manny Pacquiao's in Bob Arum's camp. Manny Pacquiao is not getting the money that is widely reported he has received over the years. At least that's what they say about him. So with all of those things...
Do you really think he has money problems?
Yeah, I was going to say, explain that.
I do believe that, but here's why. It's not because, you know, he's irresponsible with it. It's because he's incredibly charitable with it. The people in the Philippines, obviously he's incredibly loyal to those folks, and he's incredibly philanthropic in his homeland. And as a result, he takes his money and he goes back. And listen, man, you know when you've got money. I mean, we're here in America. You understand? This is the greatest country in the world by and large in most of our eyes, okay? Yes. And if you got a little cash, there's always somebody around with their hand out looking for you to either give them some of your money or invest in a way that will help them make money. Well, if it's that way here in the great United States of America, could you imagine how it is in the Philippines? So I look at it from that standpoint. His generosity, I've heard on many occasions he's going to Bob Arum and asked for advances to his payday because of work that he was doing and the charitable donations and things of that nature. So when you are that generous and that philanthropic, you can find yourself in an incredible hole where you need to fight. Mm-hmm. And that's what's going on here.
What's going on here is that this is a man who says, if I have to fight this same dude a fifth time, and you will pay me $15 million to do it, I think I might save $5 million, so I'll fight him in the islands as opposed to in Las Vegas. It's as simple as that. And if you want to really know the truth of this question, I'm going to change the question a little bit. What's really going on here is that now we know for a fact Floyd Mayweather Jr. is off the hook. And I'm talking about the right hook, as in he is safe from the right hook of Manny Pacquiao, or the left hook, whichever you want. You can have either one of them, because now Floyd knows he doesn't have to run anymore. Now Floyd knows that there's no way he has to fight Pacquiao ever. It's over. It's off. And the only reason Pacquiao was hanging in was to fight Floyd, because Pacquiao sat right there and then convinced you through the rest of the day as he did your radio show that he would beat Floyd. I believed it from the start. I think he not only would have beaten him, he would have given him a beating.
First of all, you don't you dare attribute that to me. He didn't convince me that he would beat Floyd.
He
gave me cause to pause as it pertained to Floyd Mayweather not willing to fight him. I have always maintained that Floyd Mayweather would give him a boxing lesson. I have never wavered on that position.
Floyd running?
Well, excuse me, I never felt Floyd was running.
Yes,
I told you that Pacquiao gave me cause for pause because I couldn't believe how bold he was. I said, this boy really thinks he could beat Floyd Mayweather.
Oh,
He has a lot of nerve yeah. in thinking that. Now, let me tell you something right now. You keep ruling out the possibility. I think the fact that he's gotten knocked out, if he comes back and beats Marquez, if he fought Marquez and he beat Marquez, I'm sorry, you'd see the rumblings, returning, and people would be calling for him to fight Floyd.
You'd see Floyd at what, age 40 by then, or what?
I'm just telling you, you'd see people asking for the fight. Don't rule out that, oh my goodness. Now, you can rule out the possibility of Pacquiao winning against Floyd, but don't rule out the possibility that the fight would actually take place. Because if Manny Pacquiao come out and somehow resurrects himself, let's say, for example, he knocks out Marquez, all right? Excuse me, that's a big deal. And I'm here to tell you, people will be clamoring for that fight against Floyd.
I'm here to tell you.
Knockouts happen in boxing. Hearns got knocked out. People still wanted to see his fights.
Styles make fights. A tough style for Manny is Marquez.
I agree.
It was from the start.
I agree.
He had a hard time with
it. A tough fight for Marquez. Could you imagine what Floyd would think?
Nope.
You still think Floyd can beat him?
Styles would make that fight. And that fight would belong to Pacquiao. Because he can outquick Floyd, and he can definitely outpunch Floyd.
So he can outquick Floyd, but got caught and put to sleep by Marquez. You shouldn't be talking to me about boxing.
I'm trying to tell you. He had him in so much trouble. He got cocky. He lost his focus, and he said, "Oh, I'll just swing wildly here at the end of the round."
Great,
and he got caught.
Great. Undisputed middleweight champion of the world for 20 fights, Bernard Hopkins, came on this show and educated you that what happened. He educated you that Pacquiao, that was like losing 10 fights.
Yeah, at this point, I don't think Bernard can remember his own name.
He called you Stu.
Yeah, Stu.
Excuse me. Bernard still wins. He still wins. Respect the man.
I can't. Not that opinion. I don't respect that opinion.
He said that 10 fights, like losing 10 fights. You understand? You understand what it gets to get put to sleep? I mean, literally, like you out for the night. Oh, I'm taking a nap. No, that's what happened to Manny Pacquiao. Skip. You know how the skull and the brain have to collide for that to happen to you?
But Floyd could knock me out.
Please.
Come on.
Please.
Floyd could knock me out.
I got to get Money Mayweather in here. Yeah. The nonsense you talk. It's just so educated.
How about Floyd
sit here and educate you? I wouldn't even try.
Pacquiao could beat Mayweather if Mayweather didn't wear gloves. Because he wouldn't get hit.
Please.
Come on.
The pillow fighting.
Yeah.
Come on.
Pillow fighter.
Please. That man gives...